Moving on, our next speaker is Tony Lynch, founder of Paxi. Tony's had his own businesses, technology businesses, since the age of 24, including digital books, I believe, with Andy right now. But please, tell us all about Paxi.
Does that work?
Good afternoon, good morning everybody. My name is Tony Lynch and I am the CEO and co-founder of a company called Faxi. Got a bit of a cold as you can hear. Now Faxi is a corporate ride sharing platform and Lucid is not easy. Actually it's really hard. As anyone who's building software platforms will tell you, it is really hard for a lot of reasons. Actually, ride sharing, ride sharing is the tech company graveyard. In the last couple of months, companies funded by TPG, who have spent over $20 million on this, have closed. Lyft, who has currently received over $2 billion building its ride share platform, has given up on the kind of corporate commuting ride sharing platform. So, and I think this is one of the things about mobility as a service. A lot of it doesn't work. We all talk about apps. Let's build another app. I hear it all the time. What we need is another app. There's 300 apps. Who's got them? Who's using them? A lot of the time we forget about the customer and about the return on investment and about the method of engagement. So what I thought I'd talk to you a little bit about today is a couple of user case studies, the projects that we're running utilizing shared mobility. So what we've learned working with large companies and their users. So like any good story, we start with data. Okay, now this is 2,115 employees of Santander. Santander and Milton Keynes. And as you can see, the reason why companies are spending millions on this, they estimate that personal transport is a $10 trillion opportunity. You can see for people like me, that represents a massive opportunity. That's live data, that's real commuters traveling backwards and forwards to the same place. They live virtually on top of each other. And if you actually optimize their routes, you can see that the employees of Santander in Milton Keynes haven't got one person to share with, they've got hundreds of people to share with. Okay. But, as you know, it's bloody hard to get them to share. So we had to look at specific issues of why people will or won't share. So Santander have come to us and they have a very particular problem. As we've already heard, Milton Keynes, there is nowhere left to park. You cannot park, it's a massive cause of a dissatisfaction for customers. Before we go on to the problem with Santander, let's talk about the analysis of commuter journeys. So for these three big companies that we're talking about today, over 10,000 daily commuters, if you map out their journeys, or if you map out their home locations, you can see between 66 and 68% of people could share their car journey to and from work with multiple co-workers who live less than a 10-minute walk away. Okay, so you can see the size of the opportunity. And we've actually analysed over the last 6 months 150,000 journeys in Sweden, in the UK, and in Ireland. And in all of those large organisations, we see very similar things. Okay, this is the algorithm we use to try and understand who could share with who. At the moment, we're only talking about proximity algorithms, so people could share based upon their proximity to home location. If you go to a route matching algorithm, the sharing opportunity increases again. Okay, so you can just see that. Okay, so let's talk about the actual user. Let's fully understand the problem. As we've already established, Milton Keynes has horrific car parking problems. And so we did a survey with Santander for their employees, and 67% confirmed that parking was their biggest issue. Okay? And so we said, okay, well, so what would make you share? What would solve this problem? And as you can see here, you can see that from those 1,500 people, we got some feedback from those users. And obviously the biggest issue here is to help finding someone with a suitable journey pattern. And obviously we've got here reserved car parking for car sharers. So what we now know is that there's a genuine requirement from these people who live on top of each other to find a way of travelling together. So what have we done? So Santander have worked with us to do mobile-enabled transportation. Okay, so people talk about mobility as a service. I really think it's mobile-enabled. Uber is a mobile-enabled transportation. So what we've done with Santander is they've decided that to help solve the car parking problem for their community, they will take their 300-space car park and they will make it prioritised, dynamically prioritised, for those commuters that transport co-workers. Okay, you can just quickly see here, there is a video, the fact is up, we can send that around later, but I don't think we've got time to go through it. But let me take you through this, how this works in a technical way. This is the actual car park. As you can see, this is prime land. You've got the railway station here, and Santander on that area there. And that's full by 7:30 every morning, with most of those commuters sitting in their car for an hour before they go to work. Okay, the actual stat there is 1 in 7 commuter drivers in the UK gets to work an hour early just to get a car parking space. So what we've done, and say platforms aren't that easy, we've come up with this mobile-enabled transport system where we've created a smartphone app that basically does this. So, we have a map-based app, another app on top of the other 300, a map-based app where you can see your co-workers and you can set up a shared journey. When you set up a shared journey, the driver starts the journey, the passenger accepts the journey, and then the passenger can see the real location of the driver as they travel to the destination. But that's not the magic, that's just an app. Where the magic actually happens is here. Because what we do in the background is while that transaction is going through, we're running some patent apply for technology which proves people are car sharing in real time, and then we are installing at that car park a barrier system which is dynamically linked to this database. As you drive, as a driver carrying a co-worker, as you drive up to that barrier, it will recognise your vehicle registration number or your security access card, and it will know that you are car sharing. If you're car sharing, the barrier goes up. If you're not car sharing, you either pay or the barrier doesn't go up. Okay, so this is an example of mobile-enabled transport. We're using the mobile phone first to make some connections, first to enable some communication, but more importantly, to prove that people are car sharing in real time, to enable Santander to provide 300 spaces, which are currently valued at £600 per space per year. Okay, so every people now who are car sharing are paying back, so it's saving £600 a year, plus they get the contribution costs from their co-workers. This is the first time this technology has been launched anywhere in the world, I think. It's the first time that you've got proof of car share linked to a car park, which we will be managing. So that's the platform that we've developed. That's the solution that we provided for the problems that we've identified. And you can see that this is replicatable. Northampton County Council are moving to a new office. Northampton County Council are moving to a new office. You can see this is their staff. This is their optimised journeys. We're repeating that software platform in the in their car park. There's 60 spaces which you will automatically access via a proof of car share solution similar to Santander. And then finally, talking about Vodafone, using exactly or using similar smartphone technology, as you can see here again, these are the employees of Vodafone at their head office in Newbury. This is the optimized routes. What we're starting to do here is we're clearly identifying upfront who are the drivers who can park on site, and the red and blue icons are contractors who have to park off site, adding an hour to their commute each day. What we can do now is create an incentive where those drivers who can park on site can pick up their contractor partners, saving them an hour and saving the driver £1,000 a year. And that's what it looks like when you actually look at the live taxi site as it is presented here now. Thank you very much.